All right, guys, so the next topic that we have is third normal form, or nothing but 3NF. So what exactly is third normal form? There are two conditions for a data to be in third normal form. The first one is it must be in second normal form. And the next condition is there should not be any transitive dependency. So no transitive dependency. So what exactly is transitive dependency? Let us consider one example. Let's take, we have a table, student ID, and then we have student name. Next we have city, and then we have zip code. Now, if you look at this table, and we can see and say that student ID is nothing but the key column, right? It's the key column. Perfect. Student name is a non-key column. City is non-key. And zip, by default, we know that it is a key column. Perfect. Now, in this case, how the dependency works. You can see we can find the student name via student ID also. We can find city via the student ID also. And we can find city via the zip also. Now, what exactly is transitive dependency? The transitive dependency means changing one column value will impact another column value change. For example, if a student changes their address, let's take their zip ID has been changed, right? So the earlier zip ID was 1001 and now the zip ID is 30004. If we change the zip column or zip ID column in this table, we have to always change the city also based upon the zip. So this becomes a transitive dependency. What exactly is a transitive dependency? Change in one column impacts change in another column. Now, if there is a transitive dependency like this, what you have to do is put this one in another table. So what are the two new tables that we have? We have students table, and in the student table, we have student ID, student name, and then we have zip. And then we have another table that's called zip codes, where we have the column name zip ID, and then the second one would be city. Now in this way, this is a key column in the zip code table. Student ID is the key column in the students table. If a student changes the zip code, we do not have to change the city column inside the student table, right? Because we do not have any city column inside the student table. Now the city column is residing inside the zip code table. So what we do is we just update the zip codes, and the new zip code city name can be queried from the zip codes table. So this way, we are removing the transitive dependency. So one important thing you need to remember in third normal form is there should not be any transitive dependency. What exactly is the transitive dependency? Change in one column should not impact or should not force you to change value in any other column. As I mentioned earlier, there are more types of normalization forms, but for your certification and for your understanding, third normal form is more than enough.